गुड मॉर्निंग वंदन।
ओके
डिस्कशन अबाउट ऑल पास फिल्टर पर्पस। सी लो पास फिल्टर मींस व्हिच विल ट्राई टू अलो लो फ्रीक्वेंसी कंपोनेंट्स, विच विल ट्राई टू रिजेक्ट हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी कंपोनेंट्स। हाई पास फिल्टर्स मींस इट विल ट्राई टू अलो हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी कंपोनेंट्स एंड इट विल ट्राई टू रिजेक्ट लो फ्रीक्वेंसी कंपोनेंट्स। All pass filters means it will try to allow all frequency components through that filter. It won't reject anything. But the purpose of this one is, what are the main purpose of all pass filters? We are using this for to remove phase dispersion, right? To remove phase dispersion. For example, let me consider some x of n. This is my input x of n passed through channel with impulse response hc of n. This is channel. Hc of n is a LTI system channel impulse response. And suppose if I got some y of n as my output, and let me consider the transfer function of this one is as follows. Equals to mod hc of e power j omega. This is let. Suppose if this is my transfer function, mod h of e power j omega, right? For example, mod h of e power j omega is something like minus k into omega plus pi of omega. Let me call this like a non-linear function. Okay, let me have like this. Non-linear function of omega, this part. Non-linear function of omega. Now my phase corresponds to minus k omega plus minus pi omega. Minus k omega minus pi omega corresponds to minus k omega minus pi of omega. Pi of omega corresponds to my phase, this whole thing, where this part corresponds to non-linear phase with respect to frequency omega. But if you want to avoid phase dispersion, we required a system with a linear phase. In order to avoid phase dispersion, I'll try to design a system in such a manner that it'll try to cancel this effect. With the receiver, I'll try to plan this one, some equalizer. HEQ means equalizer. In such a manner that H equalizer of e power j omega equals to, let me design something like this. I'll try to cancel this term. Minus j into k1 omega, where k1 is some constant, minus pi of omega. If I'm able to design my system as follows with this phase, then what happens is it will be multiplied, right? If this is hc of e power j omega, if this is HEQ of e power j omega, and both are LTI systems in cascade, then effectively what happens is the overall system response will be multiplication of this one with this, right? HEQ of e power j omega into HEQ of e power j omega. Once you multiply this one with this one, it will get cancelled out, minus pi of omega and pi of omega. And effectively I am going to get mod HEQ of e power j omega into e power minus j into k1 plus k2 into omega. Now this k1 plus k into k1 k plus k1 into omega is a linear phase, right? Linear with respect to omega. It means that we are able to avoid that phase dispersion or delay dispersion with the help of this equalizer, right? That's what we had done. That's what our plan with the help of all pass filters. See, you can see this one. This is having gain of 1, unit gain. mod of this one is equal to 1 for all omega. Having a gain 1, but this is non-linear phase. We'll try to plan an all-pass filter with this property so that this can be cancelled out. And effectively, we are going to end up with the linear phase system, this overall system. That's our plan with the help of all-pass filters. We'll try to compensate that effect. The delay dispersion will be removed with the help of all-pass system. That's what our target. Let us recap this one. This is the all-pass filter transfer function. H first order all-pass filter transfer function. H all-pass of z equals z power minus 1 minus a star by 1 minus a z power minus 1. For a causal system, that ROC should be outside of that pole, right? Yeah, just only one pole. Z equal to a is the pole of this one. ROC should be outside of that pole. Mod z should be greater than mod a for a causal system. And if you are expecting that one also to be stable one, for stability mod z equal to 1 should be part of ROC, right? So this mod a should be less than 1 for stability, stable and causal system. And you can see we have pole at z equal to a, 0 at z equals to 1 by a star. If you equate this numerator to 0, z power minus 1 minus a star equal to 0 implies z equals to 1 by a star. It means we have 0 at 1 by a star and pole at a. The most general form of system function of an all-pass system with real world impulse response is product of factors like this. Okay, I'll ask something. Let me consider ax square plus bx plus c equals to x minus roots. Let me call the roots as follows. X minus r1 into x minus r2. These are two roots of this polynomial. What is the condition for abc to be real? Yeah, when these things will be real, can you just tell me in terms of this R1, R2? First case is R1 and R2, both should be real. Both R1 and R2 should be real. If these two are real, then if you multiply them, then we are going to end up with real coefficients only, all of them. If R1 is complex, then what should be R2 in order to get real coefficients?
Complex.
Yeah, this should be complex conjugate of that one, right? This is from PUC background. You can try to recollect this one. This should be complex conjugate of this one. These two should be complex conjugate of each other. Then you can try to have real coefficients after this multiplication. Yeah, here we are trying to plan for h alpha sub z equals to p of z by q of z, ratio of two polynomials with real coefficients, p of z by q of z, right? And the coefficients of p of z polynomial should be real. The coefficients of q of z polynomial should be real. We are expecting that one. See, when the coefficients of when all the coefficients are real, then we can expect the impulse response will be real. If all the coefficients of that h of z are real, that z power minus n coefficients are there, right? If all of them are real, then by default we can expect that our impulse response h of n will also be real. It means our major concern is about real h of n, real impulse responses. For that we need to maintain real coefficients in the denominator polynomial and real coefficients in the numerator polynomial. That's what we need to maintain. Yeah, you can have a look into this one. As you already saw in the last session, this is the all pass filter transfer function, first order. Z power minus 1 minus A star by 1 minus A Z power minus 1. Suppose A is real, A is a real, then A star equals to A, right? In that scenario, this will be Z power minus 1 minus A by 1 minus A Z power minus 1. When A is real, is the case where the pole is real, the poles are real. Forget about this product term, just look into this one. Z power minus 1 minus dk by 1 minus dk into z power minus 1. Here the pole is z equals to dk is the pole, and 0 corresponds to z equals to 1 by d. Z equals to 1 by dk is 0. Z equals to dk, z equals to dk is the pole in this case. We are just cascading all pass filters. Yeah. Can you just comment about this? All pass 1 of Z. And let me consider this H. All pass 2 of Z. All pass, different all pass systems. H. All pass 3 of Z. All of them are alpha systems only, then my overall system will be, and everyone is LTA. Can you just tell me what is my overall system transfer function? What is H of Z? It's a product, right? It's a multiplication of all of these transfer functions. H alpha 3 of Z. The multiplication of one of them. Okay. Can you say this is also all pass system? Is it all pass? Suppose these three are all pass systems. Can you comment about this? Is it all pass system? See, this is also all pass system. Is it true? If these are all pass system, this is also all pass system. The reason is, you can have DTFT, right? In DTFT, mod H of E equals J omega equals to, replace Z with E equals J omega, equals to mod ABC equals to mod A into mod B into mod C, right? Mod H alpha 1 of E equals J omega into mod H alpha 2 of E equals J omega into mod H alpha 3 of E equals J omega. Then what is this value? This is 1, right? This is 1 for all omega. This is also 1 for all omega. 1 for all omega. Because this is an alpha system. Let me consider alpha system with a gain of 1. See, this need not be always equals to 1. This should be some constant. It can be some k. K into k into k. That's also fine. This need not be always 1. Alpha system means. I should try to provide constant gain, which is non-zero. Non-zero constant gain for all frequency components. Then you can call it as alpha filter or alpha system. Need not be gain of 1 every time. That should maintain a constant gain. That's enough. Just for simplicity, let me consider all of them are having a constant gain, and which is equal to 1. Now 1 into 1 into 1 is 1, right? Once again, this is an alpha system. To try to cascade alpha filters, we are going to end up with once again alpha system, right? That's what we are doing here. We are trying to cascade MR, capital MR number of all pass filters. Then they will be multiplied, right? The, after multiplication, this will be once again all pass filter only. You are just cascading MR all pass filters. The effective filter after cascading also will be all pass filter. With the gain of this one is 1. Gain of this one is 1, once again. It's just a multiplication. MR, R corresponds to real. R means real. You are just bothering about real poles, right? Real pole systems. You are having MR number of real pole alpha systems, and you are just cascading them. They get multiplied, right? Their transfer functions. And this corresponds to Is it real pole or complex pole? This one, at least from based on this terminology. See, these are corresponds to complex poles. Here dk corresponds to real pole. You are having m r number of real poles, and here ek corresponds to complex pole. This can be a complex pole. In order to maintain real coefficients, if you are having complex root, there should be complex conjugate for that, right? That's what we are doing here. Here the pole is ek, which is complex. We already have one more pole, which is complex conjugate of this one, ek star. So that after multiplication, it will have only real coefficients. That's what our plan. Okay, let me write this once. As you already know that one reference alpha system is z power minus 1 minus a star by 1 minus a z power minus 1. Suppose a is real, a star will be a. Okay, that is fine. Now I want to make it like a real coefficient system. Then how to do this one? 1 minus a z power minus 1. If a is complex, then I will try to do something like this. Here I will try to do reverse for that. A. Replacing a with a star, then a star will become a, right? I'm just replace that one. Okay, then what about this one? Is it alphas? We already know that this is alphas, right? See, alphas filter. Then what about this? This is also an alphas filter, right? This is also alphas filter. These two are alphas filters only. Because see, only we need to do is we need to maintain that this one to be complex conjugate of this one. You can see a star whole star equals to a, right? We just maintain that complex conjugate property. So the gain of this one is 1, gain of this one also 1 for all omega. These two are alpha systems. If we cascade them, we are going to end up with once again alpha system. That means no need to worry about this one, right? This entire thing corresponds to cascading of several alpha systems. Cascading of several number of alpha systems leads to once again alpha system only. The gain of this overall system is 1. 1 into A, some constant A, which is not equal to 0. This is some constant. A can be 1 also. Up to this part, if you own the gain, this will be equal to 1 for all omega. Once you replace Z with E equals omega, and if you do that analysis, then you are going to get gain is A into 1, which is equal to A for all omega. Okay, can someone tell me what are the zeros? Just construct this system. What are the poles of this system? Forget about this multiplication pattern. Just construct this one. Yeah, can someone answer? What are the poles of this?
Ek, ek star.
Yes, ek and ek star, right? And what are the zeros of this?
1 by ek star and ek.
Yes, 1 by ek star and 1 by ek, right? 1 by ek star and 1 by ek are zeros of this system. Ek and ek star are poles of this system. Once you multiply them, then you are going to end up with real coefficients only. You will get some numerator polynomial, right? Which will contain only real coefficients after this multiplication. And after multiplying this denominator things, then you are going to end up with real coefficient denominator polynomial. Finally, it leads to real impulse response, H of n, overall impulse response. That's what we want. Yeah, this is a general template for alpha system. Once again, for causal and stable alpha system, for causality means, yeah, for causal and stable alpha system, what do you need to maintain? Merges should be right side of outside of outermost pole, right? Merges should be outside of outermost pole for a causal system. You are having several poles, right? Pole at DK, EK, and so on, right? Where K from 1 to MC, C means complex, like that again thing. R means real. You are having total how many poles? How many poles you are having? You have MR poles from this, MR poles. From here, you are having how many poles?
MC.
MC plus MC, right? You have two poles, two each. Two,
yes,
MC. Two MC plus MR. These many number of poles we are having total. Out of these many number of poles, we'll try to pick the pole with highest magnitude. Then our ROS will be marginally greater than that one. Then that will be a causal system. And for stability, that should be inside the unit circle, right? For stability, all poles should be inside the unit circle. All poles should be inside the unit circle means mod DK should be less than 1 for all K equal to 1 to MR. Mod EK should be less than 1 for all K equals to 1 to MC. No need to worry about EK star because mod EK equals to mod EK star. The magnitude of complex conjugate is same as magnitude of that itself, right? Both are same. Okay, typical pole zero plot for an all-pass system. Yeah, you can have a look into this one carefully. This is my unit circle, mod z equal to 1. This is mod z equal to 1, this z plane, real coordinate, imaginary coordinate. Okay, let me do something. This corresponds to mod z equal to 1. The jet plane. Okay, let me consider I have a pole at this location. This is 1, right? Then let me consider this like a 0.8, for example, 0.8. And then where should be my zero, corresponding zero? Okay, let me try to revise that once again. 1 minus A z pole minus 1. We have pole at A, then what is the corresponding zero? Corresponding zero to this one in this alpha system. 1 by A star, right? 1 by A star. Yeah. Then where is my corresponding zero for this? Yeah, can you answer this?
1 by 0.8.
1 by 0.8 means, is it less than 1 or more than 1? 1 by less than 1 means that should be more than 1, right? 1 by 0.8, that should be above 1 and still positive, right? Okay, that is 0.
It's 1.25.
Yeah, somewhere around here, right? See, 1 by 0.8. 1 by 0.8. I have 0 at 1 by 0.8. Okay, let me consider 0 with this. Yeah. Suppose I have pole at this location, minus 1 by 2. Then where should be my concerned zero for this? If that is alpha system. You can apply this trick.
Minus 2, sir.
1 by A star means that is minus 2, right? We are going to have 0 at minus 2. Because inverse and complex conjugate of this, right? Okay, that is fine. Now let me consider a pole at this location. And yeah, let me consider pi by 4 exactly. Let me say, mod z should be less than 1, right? Mod z should be less than 1. Let me call this as K Can someone give me any pole value for this? R e power j theta. Yeah, that will be comfortable for me. And then I'll try to have 0.7 e power the theta, right? R e power j theta means this is my theta. J pi by 4. Let me ensure this is pi by 4 angle. This is my pole, one of the poles. And if you want to have real coefficients, if you want to have real coefficients, then you need to have one more pole, right? Yeah, what is that one more pole?
Conjugate.
That should be complex conjugate of this one, right? This implies this one, one more thing. Complex conjugate of this one is nothing but 0.7 e power minus j pi by 4, right? J pi by 4. This is my one more pole. Okay, that's fine. Then what are the corresponding zeros? Corresponding zero for this one. 1 by A star, right? If this is my pole A, I should have 0 at 1 by A star. 1 by A star means 1 by 0.7 into e power j pi by 4. It means 1 by 0.7 into e power minus j pi by 4, right? 1 by 0.7. Oh, complex conjugate of this, right? E power minus j pi by 4, which is equals to 1 by 0.7 e power j pi by 4. Okay, this is once again, it's same angle pi by 4, right? It's pi by 4 continued, but magnitude is above 1. 1 by 0.7 means more than 1, right? I'll have 0 somewhere here. See my 0. 1 by 0.7 into e power j pi by 4. Then what about this? The concerned 0 for this? This will be 1 by 0.7, the complex conjugate for this, e power j pi by 4 equals to 1 by 0.7 into e power minus j pi by 4, right? This is this one. Otherwise, you can simply have this, right? You just take complex conjugate for this. This is a complex conjugate of this, right? Now, one observation we can have from this is, if you want a stable and causal all pass filter, stable and causal all pass filter, all poles should be inside the unit circuit. You can have a look into this. All the poles are inside the unit circuit according to our theory of the transforms. All poles should be inside the unit circuit for stable and causal systems. All are inside the unit circuit, right? Then what about zeros? Concerned zeros, are they inside the inner circuit or outside? Have a look into this. Everyone is outside the inner circuit, right? All the zeros corresponding to a stable and causal all pass filter are outside the inner circuit. No one is inside the inner circuit, right? All poles are inside the inner circuit, but all zeros are outside of that one due to this property, right? You have pole at A, you have 0 at 1 by A star. For all pass systems. Yeah, this is one such example. And some of the applications of all pass filters are they'll try to remove delay dispersion introduced by the channel, or they'll try to remove that phase dispersion, right? For that purpose, you are taking the help of all pass systems. And we had a mistake in the last class. We missed this R here during the session. I had an up to this correctly, but somehow I missed this part, R into sine omega minus theta. You can correct that. It's a nonlinear phase, right? Nonlinear phase system. And similarly, we can try for that complex conjugate, that complex pole system. This is my complex pole. Let me consider z power minus 1 minus a star by 1 minus a z power minus 1. Replace z with e power j omega. Replace z with e power j omega. That's what we have done. and we have pole at r e power j theta. Let me replace a equal to r e power j theta. This is nothing but z power minus 1 minus a star by 1 minus a z power minus 1. Replace z with e power j omega and replace a with r e power j theta. Then a star will be r e power minus j theta, right? Similarly, you can go for complex conjugate pole and complex conjugate zero for this, so that you can have real coefficients finally, right? Now, if you try to compute the phase of this one in the similar manner, like this, exactly in the similar manner, then our phase will be this one. We are going to end up with this phase. It's a non-linear phase, right? This part corresponds to non-linearity in the phase. This part, which will be responsible in order to remove that phase dispersion, right? You can try to tune this r and theta in such a manner that pi of omega will be cancelled out, where pi of omega is the non-linear phase introduced by the channel. Some observations for real coefficients in transfer function. Let me consider a1 of z equals to a plus z power minus 1 by 1 plus a z power minus 1 for real a is the first order IAR alpha system. Okay, is it true or false? Is it all-pass filter? Okay, let me rewrite this once again. Till now, what are the basic thing that we studied is 0 at 1 by A star and pole at A star, pole at A, right? Yeah. This what we have studied till now. For stability and causal system, margin should be above mod A. Now, the system here is a plus z power minus 1 by 1 plus a z power minus 1. See, these two are equal. There is no difference at all. Here, a is real. A real means a star equals to a, right? Z power minus 1 plus a divided by 1 plus a z power minus 1. I have rewritten this one. I am claiming that these two forms are equal. Because a star equal to a means I can have this, right? If I replace a star with a, I am going to end up with this one, except this minus sign. I can take minus inside, right? I'll try to call this minus a as my updated a. That's what I am claiming. That's it. No need to worry about this. You don't require minus for this one. That's not mandatory. You need to maintain same sign for this and this. That's enough, right? You can think of this like this. I have done something like plus half minus a plus half minus a star. I am trying to call minus a like my updated a. That's what I am doing here. Like that you can think. And when a is real, a star will be a, right? That's what we have done. This is still an all-pass system. It's an all-pass system only. This can be rewritten like this. Okay, is it true or false? It's a claim. Z power minus 1 plus a divided by 1 plus a z power minus 1, which is nothing but numerator polynomial divided by denominator polynomial p of z by q of z. The claim here is that is equal to z power minus 1 into z power minus 1 divided by q of z. Okay, is it true or false? This is my claim. These two are equal. For the first order alpha system, this is first order, right? For the first order alpha system. First order means this z power is 1, right? Minus 1 is first order. Only one delay element. Yeah, what is this? Is it okay? See, this is my Q object. Yeah, let me try to rewrite this. Q object equals 1 plus a z power minus 1. Then my Q of z power minus 1 will be 1 plus a z, replacing z with z power minus 1. Z power minus 1 whole power minus 1 equal to z, right? It's true. Now I am doing this one, multiplying with z power minus 1. Z power minus 1 into Q of z power minus 1 equals to z power minus 1 plus a into z power minus 1 into z means a, right? Z power minus 1 plus a. See, nothing but this one. It's equal, right? Similarly, for an nth order system, for an nth order all pass filter, you can try to write something like this. It's a generalized expression for that nth order one. It's a generalized one. For an nth order all pass filter, I can try to have this one like which is equals to P of Z by Q of Z. I can try to write this in terms of Q, the denominator. Q of Z, earlier I had done with Z power minus 1, right? Now I will do with Z power minus N. Q of Z power minus 1. Yeah, like this we can express. In terms of denominator polynomial, I can express this numerator polynomial. It's possible. Here Q of Z, this is nth order polynomial, right? 1 plus D1 Z power minus 1. See, once you multiply them, we are going to get nth order polynomial, right? What I am doing here is, I'm just multiplying all these denominator options. Finally, I'll try to end up with this one, right? Nth order polynomial. Yeah, like that you can think. Cascading of n first order systems, for example. Then I'm going to end up with nth order polynomial in the denominator and nth order polynomial in the numerator. You see my denominator polynomial. That's why I am mentioning with the D. D means denominator. Like that you can think. The coefficients. 1 plus D1 z power minus 1 plus D2 z power minus 2 plus and so on. Dn z power minus n. Nth order, right? Nth order denominator polynomial. Then my numerator polynomial P of z will become like z power minus n into Q of z power minus 1. Can someone tell me what is this P of z once you multiply this? See, if I do Q of z power minus 1 here, this will become z. This will become z square. This will become z power n minus 1 and this will become z power n. This minus will go out, right? The minus in the exponent will go out. Z power n, z power n minus 1, z square, z power 1 like this. And coefficients will be remain same. Now multiply with z power minus n. Then this z power n gets cancelled out because this is plus, right? Earlier after this operation. This gets cancelled out and here you are going to get z power minus 1. Z power minus 2, z power minus 3 and so on. Here we are going to end up with z power minus n. This will be z power minus of n minus 1. This will be reversed, right? Coefficients in the reverse order. Yeah, I can have a look into this one. After this multiplication, we are going to end up with the coefficients in the reverse order. You can see 1, d1, d2 up to dn, right? This is in the reverse order. Dn, dn minus 1, dn minus 2 and so on up to 1. Exactly in the reverse order. This order we are writing here, right? In the reverse way. And these are the coefficients of them. This is representing an all-pass system. It means if someone asks you that this is my denominator polynomial for the all-pass system, you can compute the numerator polynomial just by reversing the coefficients. You can reverse the coefficients, right? Dn you can write first. After that, dn minus 1 you can write. Dn minus 2 and so on up to 1. Before this one, d1 is there. That's it. Like that, you can reverse the order. You can get the coefficients straight away. You can realize any kind of filter. Realize means you can implement. You can implement any kind of filter with the help of all pass filters. It's possible. We'll have to have a look into that later. Okay, let's have a look into this one. Yeah, can someone tell me what's happening here? Let me consider this is my audio signal. Let me consider this one as my audio signal. Audio signal means the frequency components will be from 20 Hz to 20 kHz roughly. 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Some song, consider some song. And this corresponds to gain. G0 means gain. G1 means gain. G2 means some gain. Some amplification factor. Some constant. Okay, I'll ask some question so that you can understand well. Suppose this is my X of N. This is my X of N. Then what will be this output?
G0 into X of N.
Yes. This will be G0 into X of N. What I am doing here is, I am passing this X of N straight away through this amplifier. At the output, everything gets added, right? This is summation. This is getting added to this one, and that is getting added with this. Finally, that is getting added to this one. Okay, let me consider some filters. Some filters means, okay, for example, yeah. Just for my convenience, let me try to simplify that. Let me consider this is my speech signal. Oh, not speech. Let me consider audio. It means some sound. Okay, what's my plan of action is I'll try to do this thing. Let me call this like G1 gain, G2, G3, and G4, and I will try to add all these things. This is adder. I am adding all these outputs, and this is my final output Y of N. Let me give the equivalent cutoff frequencies for this. FC equals to, let me say, 4 kilohertz. And let me consider, see, I should not mention in kilohertz, right? I should mention this in radians, omega, right? Omega C equals to pi by something. Omega from 0 to pi interval. I'm just writing equivalent cutoff frequencies. See, I'm trying to write this one. Omega equals to 2 pi f by fs, right? Implies f equals to omega into fs by 2 pi. I'm simply trying to write this one. That's it. equivalent analog signal. Equivalent analog signal we can rest for intuition purpose. You can try to map this one to omega c. 2 pi into fc by fs. Like that you can write. There is no issue for me. Let me consider fs equals to 44 kilo samples per second. Yeah, like that you can imagine. The concerned digital frequency omega can be found with the help of this one. It's a digital filter, right? It's not analog filter. I'm just mapping that one to concerned analog frequency, analog cutoff frequency. That's what I'm doing here. Let me consider this one corresponds to equivalent to analog low pass filter with the cutoff frequency 4 kHz. This one is equivalent to band pass filter with cutoff frequency 4 kHz to 10 kHz. And band pass filter with cutoff frequency 10 kHz to 15 kHz. This is a band pass filter with cutoff frequency 15 kHz to 20 kHz. It's a pass band. It's a pass band. It's a pass band. Like that you can think. Now, if I ask you like try to enhance or try to amplify voice signal in this song, then what is your target? Which one will you increase? G1, G2, G3 or G4? See, input is some song or audio file, which is a combination of speech plus music. Speech plus music. Now, this filter is equivalent to analog low pass filter with cutoff frequency 4 kHz. And this is a band pass filter equivalent to band pass cutoff frequencies 4 kilo and 10 kilo. This is band pass with 10 kilo, 15 kilo. Band pass with 15 kHz to 20 kHz. Like that you can imagine equivalently. Now, I want to boost my speech signal. I want to amplify my speech signal a lot as compared to other music frequency components. Then which one I need to increase? G1 or G2 or G3 or G4? Yeah, can you answer? Okay, you got my question, right? Yeah, which one you need to enhance? This one, right? For example, I'll try to make G1 equals to 5. G1 equals to 5. G2 equals to 1. Let me consider G3 equals to 1 and G4 equals to 1. The meaning of this one is I'll try to amplify the speech part, because after this filtering, I'll get only speech signal and some music components below 4 kHz, right? Now I'll try to amplify this part by 5 units into 5, right? That means my speech will be amplified a lot, 5 times, right? Now let me consider that 4 kHz to 10 kHz music signal band that will be transmitted as it is. Let me consider 10 to 15 kHz that will be transmitted as it is. Let me consider 15 to 20 kHz band, it will be transmitted as it is. For example, I can try to give gain of 0.1 for this and gain of 0.1 for this one. It means I am trying to attenuate the music frequency components between 10 to 20, right? 10 kHz to 20 kHz. And I attenuate them. And I'll try to enhance my speech signal and I'll try to keep it as it is. The music components up to 4 to 10 kHz band. I'll try to keep it as it is. Now add all of them and I'll try to give this to my speaker. I'll try to listen to enhanced speech, right? Out of my audio file. Suppose I want to enhance music components and I want to suppress speech component. Then what I can do? Yeah, now you can answer.
G1 can be attenuated.
G1 can be attenuated. For example, I'll try to have G1 equals to 0.2. And I'll try to boost this one. Suppose you want to boost this one. Let me consider G1 equal to G2 equal to 2, G3 equal to some 3, and G4 equal to some 2, like that. Accordingly, we can boost. We have something like audio equalizers. You might have seen this in music concerts. Let us show you that one. is a graphic equalizer. This kind of setups you might have seen somewhere in music concerts. They'll try to do equalization for that audio input. You can have a look into this one. This corresponds to 25 hertz. Some band of frequencies around 25 hertz. This corresponds to 31 hertz. Some band of frequencies around 31 hertz. Like this, this is 100 hertz, 125 hertz. And this corresponds to 2K means 2 kilohertz. And this corresponds to 16K, 16 kilohertz. This corresponds to 20 kilohertz. See, these are not single frequency components. Some band of frequencies will be there beside 25 kilohertz. All of them are band pass filters. Like that, you can think. Band pass filter with the center frequency 25 hertz. Band pass filter with the center frequency 31 hertz. Band pass filter with the center frequency 16 kilohertz for this. Like that, you can think. Now, suppose I want to amplify my speech signal, then what I will do is up to 4 kilohertz, right? Roughly up to this 4 kilohertz band, I'll try to increase this gain. I'll try to tune this upward. Like that, I'll plan. See, downward also fine. Tuning downward also fine. Because high negative also okay, right? Gain of 3 units or gain of minus 3 units, both are same. Except some phase difference. Yeah, that phase will have some impact that we'll try to discuss later. If you want to attenuate them, you'll have to make them like almost zero. You can see this 5 kilohertz nearby 8 kilohertz band. We are trying to make it like almost zero. The gain for these bands almost zero, right? See, that's what they'll try to do with the help of graphic equalizers or that audio equalizers in any music concert. They'll try to tune this accordingly. Sometimes they'll try to enhance low frequency components, and in some occasions they'll try to suppress it. They'll try to enhance only music components. They can play with that audio file, right? Okay, let me have a look into complementary filters. Okay, yeah, instead of teaching this, you can simply go through these slides. This is part of your homework for the next week. Please go through these slides, these complementary filters. And if you have doubts, you can ask me. There's no issue with that one. Yeah, everything is very clear in this one. Please go through these slides for before coming to next week's session. Okay, until this part. Yeah, up to this, that's enough. Up to this slide, that 58th slide, you can go through this. And if you have doubts, you can ask me in the next session.